I had done one problem on testing of IC engines in the previous video. We'll continue it and we'll do some more problems. This is April-May 2017 paper. April-May 2017 paper. Question number 16. Effective diameter of the brake wheel, capital D, brake wheel dia, 360 mm. Dead load, W, dead load on the brake, 200 newton. Spring balance reading, S, 30 newton. Speed, 450 rpm. Area of indicator diagram, AI, is 420 square mm. Length of indicator diagram, length of LI, 60 mm. Spring scale, SC, I'll take spring scale, SS or SC, 1.1 bar per mm, per mm. Diameter of cylinder, small d, bore, 100 mm. Stroke, L, 150 mm. Oil, quantity of oil used, sorry, yes, MF, 0.815 kg per hour, he says. So by 60, if you divide, it is kg per minute. Calorific value, 42,000. Kilojoules per kg. Find BP, IP, mechanical efficiency, brake thermal efficiency, BSFC, that means specific fuel consumption on BP basis. So these are the readings. During a test on a single cylinder, number of cylinders is 1, and working on 4-stroke cycle. So 4-stroke cycle it is. These are important. With row break, the following data are taken. So R will be 180 mm or 0.18 meter. This will be 0.2 kilonewton. This will be 0.03 kilonewton. 4 mm square, this is okay. This will be 0.1 meter, 0.15 meter. Like that. Now, first we'll find out IP. PM is not there. So first I have to get PM. I cannot find IP without PM. So for PM, mean effective pressure, the formula is area of indicator diagram divided by length of the indicator diagram into spring reading, spring scale. You will get it in bar. 420 divided by 60 into 1.1. This will become 777.7 bar, or it is 770 kilopascal, multiplying it by 100. So IP now will be 770 into L 0.15 into pi d square 0.1 square divided by 4 into n. Small n will be 450 divided by 2 here, because it is a 4-stroke engine, that is 225, 60 here into this is 1, which even otherwise you can leave it. So many kilowatts. Now calculating it, calculating it, 770 into 0.15 into pi into 0.1 square into 225 divided by 4 divided by 60 into 1, I need not do it, will give me 3.4 kilowatt. This is IP. Next, T, brake torque, will be W minus S into R. So that is W is 0.2 minus 0.03 into R is 0.18. Subtract this, 0.17, 0.2 minus 0.03 is 0.17 into 0.18 will give me 0.0306 kilonewton meter. Next, BP. This I got. This is how much I got? 3.4. BP 2 pi NT by 60. So 2 pi. Here it will be, N will be 450 into T will be 0.0306 divided by 60. 2 into pi into 450 into 0.0306 divided by 60. That gives me 1.44 kilowatts. So I got it. 1.44 kilowatts. Next, mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is BP by IP. Getting less 0.423 or it is 42.3%. If you are giving in percentage. Next, brake thermal efficiency. Brake thermal efficiency will be BP into 60 divided by MF into CV. That is 1.44 into 60 divided by MF is 0.815 divided by 60 means it will go there into 42,000. Divided by 0.815, again divided by 42,000, will give me what? 0.151, or it is 15.1%. This is the brake thermal efficiency. You got this also. Next, BSFC. BSFC will be MF into 60 divided by BP. That is 0.815 divided by 1.44. Will give me 0.566. 66 kg per 1 BP per hour. This is BSFC. That completes that problem. There is one more problem in the same paper. The previous problem was for 10 marks. This is also for 10 marks. This is question number 17 on heat balance sheet. The problem goes like this. A test on a single cylinder four-stroke oil engine having bore 180 mm, stroke 360 mm, yielded the following results. Brake torque 0.44 kilonewton meter, MEP, mean effective pressure 7.2 bar, fuel consumption MF 3.5 kg per minute, cooling water flow MW 4.5 kg per minute, water temperature rise T2 minus T1 is 36 degrees centigrade, air fuel ratio is 25. That means air used is 25 times fuel used. Exhaust gas temperature TE 415 degrees centigrade. Room temperature, atmospheric temperature 21 degrees centigrade. Right? Then specific heat of exhaust gases SE is 1.005 kilojoule per kg degree Kelvin. Calorific value of the fuel CV 45,200 kilojoules per kg. Speed N, capital N, 286 RPM. Drop heat balance sheet. Heat balance sheet on kilojoules per minute basis. Again, this question carries 10 marks. Okay. Now, for heat balance sheet, what we require? We require BP. So first, we will find out BP. BP is equal to 2 pi n t by 60. So both n and t are known. N is 286 rpm. N is here. T is here. Both are given. So direct substitution. 2 pi into 286 into 0.44 divided by 60. That gives me 2 into pi into 286 divided into 0.44 divided by 60 will give me 13.17, or you can take it as 13.2 kilowatt. Doesn't matter, 13.2 kilowatts. Now, I don't require anything else to do heat balance sheet. So, the calculations are heat supplied is MF into CV, both are given, direct 3.5 into 45,200, 3.5 into 45,200 gives me 1,58,200 kilojoules per minute. This is the heat supplied. Next, heat converted to work, useful work. Heat converted to work is BP into 60. That is, BP is 13.2 into 60. 13.2 into 60, that is 792 kilojoules per minute. Heat carried away by cooling water. MW, SW, T2 minus T1. MW is 4.5 kg. SW is 4.2. It will not be given. Rise in temperature is 36 degrees centigrade. So 4.5. into 4.2 into 36, that works out to 680. 680.4 kilojoules per minute. Next, ME is equal to MF plus M air. So MF is 3.5 plus 3.5 into 25, because air is 25 times this thing. So 3.5 into 25 plus 3.5, that works out to 91 kgs per minute. Now heat carried away by exhaust gases, that will be MeSe into TE minus TA, that is 91 into 1.005 into 415 minus 21. 415 minus 21. 415 minus 21 equals 394 into 1.005 into 91. That works out to 36,033.3 kilojoule per minute. Next, heat unaccounted. Be 1 minus total of 2 plus 3 plus 4, that is 158,200 minus 792 plus 680.4 plus 732 plus 680.4 plus 36,033. Total of this is 37,158,200 minus answer will give me 1,94,0.3. Now you have to put it in that format. If you put it in that format, the job is completed. This carries 10 marks. Okay, this problems, if you have any other problem, you can always contact me on phone. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. I want you to subscribe and share my videos. Thank you.